rather than still going. So we say, from now, within the next 1.5 years or two, if you don't do something, we'll give you approval. I'm telling you that language works. Within a year, you are able to get one of the companies, provided them with some of these technologies to remove the quartz. Now they are sourcing their calcium carbonate locally in this country. That is how we can synergize and bring about improvements. Within a small company last year, they purchased calcium carbonate worth 150 million naira from one particular company. And now the company is expanding. When you talk about computer warehouse group that wanted to come in here, we helped computer warehouse group to become what it is today. We came with what we call a local vendor. What is happening is, if we give 10 approvals, 8 out of those approvals are on ICT. And we see the quantum of money that leaves this country as large as it is. We say we needed to do something first. What do? We got the professionals, particularly those in the ICT sector. We sat down in Lagos in 2006 and said we had to do something. What would we do? We came out with what we call a local vendor program. That local vendor program is designed to address two things: to develop the competencies of Nigerians in terms of software development, and also provide them with some kind of financial models that could help them to translate that knowledge they get into product and services. When software comes into this country, before we register it, we must ensure that there is a local vendor. The local vendor is a Nigerian computer firm that will be involved in the deployment of that software and in the maintenance of that software. If you have very intelligent Nigerians involved in the deployment, involved in the maintenance, whether they like it or not, some of the knowledge will be captured by Nigerians. That is a strategy. So we say, okay, when you involve any agreement, I'm sorry, any agreement, we have to ensure that the local vendor is there. And 40% of the annual technical services fee must come to the local vendor. They made a lot of money, and if you go to them after our 6 years, when we evaluated, they've been able to develop necessary capacities in terms of younger generations coming out with software applications. They have now even started exporting software outside the country. If you see the level of infrastructures they have put in place in Lagos, you'll be amazed. So it's for us to come with strategies, you understand, to use. Those people are not here interested for us, but it is for us to now decide the way out and ensure that the flow is strictly. I can talk to Arando. But as far as we are concerned, we continue to ensure that that local content is enshrined in whatever contract that is coming into the system. And the sources of those information, the sources of these technologies are the universities. So we need to have a database of our competencies so that at any point in time, we needed a professional in social and social areas. We just press a button, and very soon we'll start sending letters to you to give us details of the competencies we have in these universities. And these are the sources of development for our nation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Vice Chancellor, members of board. I won't take too much time, my bosses have mentioned it all, but I just want to add a few points. For the Space Agency, for the past, since 2001, when we established the Center for Physical Sciences here, co-hosted by the university, we've had a lot of research line between the university and the center, and we've had a lot of good research, innovation, products that needs to be commercialized. And this venture, or this science park, will not come at a better time, sir. I want to congratulate you for all the achievements made so far within a short while. And I know that the Ministry of Science and Technology will go back, as my boss said, to look at how the best way for us to operate. Thank you very much.
The Vice Chancellor and members of the administration. We have thought on the table right now. As I said earlier, four DGs have spoken about another Hero Energy Commission, raw materials, Shesco. I know you are around. We will just take an excuse for the tour. inputs will be collected and will be reflected in the report, so that it will not be that as we go out. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I must just to wrap up so that we have listened with rapt attention to touch most of the issues. I'm happy he mentioned the issue of packaging. Many of you, my name was Sonko Kafla, with a lot of patents. I'm working on it to move as soon as possible to Michigan State University in the United States. Michigan State University has the best packaging department in North America. So what you mentioned about packaging and preservation, that's the first thing you see to us. You can see we have a lot of focus, and you talked about, you see, I'm happy you mentioned that you've been working about the science village in 2010. You can see, no matter what you say, the first thing they talked about is we're overplanning. We have to see why we're not able to move, leave this thing on. That is why this week we are coming to commend this issue. You cannot wait until you have every space for custom and so on before you move. We already have more than enough. And if you see our diagram, we're on a move so that we understand where we're going to. You can see the hub is thriving with the Swedish collaborators. You can see the temporary science park. It's more than enough. They started in their own abandoned army barracks. The important thing is for companies to move, as you say. We've already started the lives, and I said oil serve. One of the best petroleum companies already moving. And it's already pioneering research in nanotechnology here. So it's already a functional park in every dimension. And then we have laboratory that Huawei is already on ground with certified teachers and so on. That's just what the science park is all about. The computer rollout is already on ground with a lot of other things that we are going to innovate there. I'm happy you mentioned that because it was in China that the Iranian mentioned about our technology. If he comes here now, he's no longer going to laugh at Nigeria. He'll be happy that we have something up and doing. So we have enough areas for engagement now. This is the model that everybody's talking about. You see, in Ghana, it was over planning. Is that not so? They did all the feasibility studies. They got in contact with United Nations. They got a loan. Is it functional now? No. The same thing in Botswana. They had all the money. They had all the buildings. They had all the feasibility studies. That's what the documents they gave me. And their own collapsed. But they are nothing as good as building on top. Thank you very much.
Again, when you look, you see here, you have the library. This is the admin block, this administrative block. This is administrative block. This is where you have the technology. They have a library too. All those things are already incorporated. So they have a tool on the site before bringing out the bottom line. Everything you're asking for, as I said, you tend to start building from one part.